the presentation is about the use of 3D human body data in the Istituto Oxologico Italiano, in particular part of the Body Pass project, that is a project funded by European Commission. So I start now my presentation, and if you have any question at the end, I will be more than happy to answer to your question. So first of all, I just give you a presentation of me. I'm Pietro Cipresso. I'm graduated in economics, but also in psychology. I'm a PhD in psychology, but also in communication and new technologies. I'm a psychomerchant, so I'm an expert of data analysis by using computational data. And I try to use these my competences for understanding human behavior. And part of my work is to work on the body. And this is the reason for which I am the team leader of the Oxologico unit for the Body Pass project that is focused on the body with several purposes that we'll see in the slide presentation. So let's start with the Body Pass object. And as you can see, Body Pass has several objectives. It's a European project that is at the 30 years, so it's almost finished. And this is this means that we did a lot of things. Of course, we can talk of everything, but I will talk about my part, and the part in particular of the Istituto Oxologico Italiano, that is a center of 15 hospitals in Lombardy and Piedmont in Italy. As you know, this is a very hard period, and there are a lot of issues for the COVID, but and we have been as hospital COVID center, but we managed to finish the data collection and to work on Body Pass at the same time. So this is the good news. First of all, let's see which are the objectives of Body Pass. First of all, we have to generate tools to access huge data set. As you can understand, in sectors like health or consumer goods industries, you have a lot of data that can be generated with the scan, human scan, both 3D human scan that we will see later, and the classic CT scan. As you know, CT scan is widely used in medicine to diagnostic purpose to understand human body part if there is a specific disease or something like that. So the idea of the Body Pass project is to create an interaction between the consumer good industries that have several data on body shapes and the medical application product design, that is the part that is related to a CT scan or other kind of scan for medical issues. So Body Pass aims to break the barriers between the health sector and the consumer goods sector, that are two different sectors, and permeabilize the current data silos. So this is a very important aspect because of course you have a huge amount of data, and what you want to get is to understand better which are the components of this data that are related to understanding of human body for specific purpose. But of course, the purpose of the textile, of the good consumer good industries, is different from the purpose of medical health sector. So the idea is to break these barriers and to create a communication channel between these two sectors. And finally, Body Pass has to adapt and create tools that allow a secure exchange of information of different silos. Big data analytics and generate protocol to preserve the privacy. As you know, European Commission is very devoted to respect the GDPR, that is the official legal document that a statement for the data treatment in in the European Community. Body Pass Project has the purpose also to understand how these privacy levels are treated, are dealt between the sector of medical sector and the good industries, the consumer good industries. So also GDPR, and this is the compliance to GDPR is part of the project, of course. But how we can measure and which is the way in which we can have this kind of tools. So how can we measure the body shapes? Well, practically what we did here is to create, is to use, not to create, because there are already, these are already available on the market, but we used this kind of, we can call this as a 3D body scanner. This is practically a scanner. I will explain you how it works. As you can see here, in this box, okay, you have like a cage where the human being is inside. So the idea is to have like a mini room, a small room, where the individuals go in and be scanned with different techniques, of course. Of course, this solution is perfect for clinical. It's not cheap because it costs something like 20,000 euros or something like that. Depends on which technology you use. But let's say that is from 10,000 euros to 1 million euros. So you have no limit in technologies, as you know. Well, the idea of using this cage is to have in a few seconds, so in an easy way, give to the clinicians the ability to have a scan, a total scan of body shape of the person. As you can see, this is a modulable equipment, so you can just create yours equipment, and here on the right, you can see, I can just switch me small. So here, as you can see, this is the final product. This final product is very easy. As you know, here you have this is just a way in which you can take your hand there, just take this one, and you stay in the A position. Hey, position, it's not a difficult thing. Practically, this means that you stay like that in this position and you are like that here, like so. So it's easy. It's not complex for the individuals that need to have the scan. It's not complex for the clinicians. It's very easy to be used, and it's very fast, because in 23 seconds, you are able to have the body scan. And how the scan does works? It's quite easy, actually. I show you here. As you can see here, you have stereo cameras. In total, we have two ears, and two ears. We have 8 cameras in this side, and that is the front side of the subject. And on the back side, it's the same. The same situation, so you have 16 cameras and you can scan, like with a photo, you can have a scan of the subject. And how does this works, this scan? You have like a picture front in the front and the back, and a computer software build a model. This model is built on the deepness of the dot of this picture, practically. Let's see. As you can see here, for example, I focus on the head for the moment, you have a lot of dots. These are 3D cloud of dots that are the dots that the scanner collects with the depth of the 3D scanner. Practically, since I'm doing like 16 pictures, 8 pictures in the front, 8 pictures in the back, I use stereo cameras, I can have not only the points, so the shape of my head in front and back, but I can have also the deepness of the, this dot. So I have like a 3D model, but at the moment it's not a model. I mean, it's just a cloud of dots. So from this cloud of dots, we can infer already the some measurements. Of course, this is one of the objects of 3D body pass to understand which body measurements can be related to be the to body shape. As you know, in clinical medicine, generally, what you do is to calculate the BMI. BMI is a classic index that has been used since 50 years or more, a lot of years, has been used to understand pathologies like anorexia or obesity, for example. And this is a very important point because we base our information on BMI from a medical point of view, but BMI is just based on the height of the individual and its weight. So no information about the body shape is included in the BMI. This means that is there is something missing. I want to be specific on this. BMI is an excellent tool, is an excellent index for medical purpose. And very great things have been done on based on BMI. But of course, we have now the technologies to be more precise and to have other measurements. So why not? We need to understand how to improve also clinical science. So this is a way to improve the BMI, the indexes, that remain a great tool, a great index, but of course can be maybe that there is another index that is not the BMI, that is based on other measurements that is effective. Since we get just 23 seconds to have all these measurements, maybe that it makes sense to think to new calculation, to new computation of indexes that can infer information, medical information based on the body shapes. So which are these measurements? Okay, I put here the names of these measurements. As you can see here, we have a list of measurements and here the list continue. I put myself small so you can see well. Okay, as you can see, we have list here and here. And as you know, we can read things like chest circumtape measures. And we go to see what is this one, is this part here. So of course, we can have description of the measurements, but here we have also the measures on the body. I just created a design on the body of the measurement. As you can see, it's quite easy. For example, collar circumference is this one. You can have this or this are both collar circumference. So this can be related with medical disease. We do not know. This is something that we have to discover. It's something on which we have to work, of course. But of course, since we are basing everything on BMI, maybe that with these new measurements that we can collect easily, we can have new information that are interesting for using to be used in medical science. So let's go further than this. Let's try to switch from just measurements to the creation of the body shape. And at this proposal, let's see the other slide. We have a different level of analysis that here you can see that I can infer from this body, from this shape, from this cloud of dots. The clouds of dots is not everything. We can have also, for example, a set of points here. You see these dots here, red dots, that give me information about, for example, the posture and the position. I can have this slice. This slice is just a way to see part of the body shape in a different way. This is quite known in radiology, for example, because it's what we do with the brain. We just have the slice of the brain and we understand this slide and the information inside. In that case, of course, I go to the inner part of the body, not the outside of the body, but it's the same concept. These are the measurements as we just seen have seen in the previous slide. And what is interesting, in my opinion, is the last one. That is the body shape itself. Here, I'm not interested in measurements, particular measurements, but I'm interested in body parts, the arms, the legs, the chest, and so on. So I'm interested in specific part of the body. So what we need to understand before to proceed is which are the body pass parameters. So of course we have more parameters than this. As we can see, we have different kind of body shape and different level of analysis, but which are the ones that we calculated, that we tried to understand if they were interesting for body pass. So we defined here the body model. As you can see here, you do not have a cloud of dots, but here, as you can see, you have a model of the body shape. Of course, the face is not readable, and we, with Philips, we did a huge work to create anonymous with the other partners of the project. We did a huge effort to anonymize the body faces, because as I told you in the previous slide, GDPR compliant is one of the part of that we took into account in the project. So it's an important part of the project, and it's important to make the individuals not recognizable. So to anonymize this data. So as you can see, we had a lot of data. Something interesting that we developed is also the data on, as you can see here, for example, the shape that has been the shape, for example, here, the empty part that is created, drawing a line from the back to below, so the below and the upper side of the body. So this part can be important to understand problem in the posture of the subject for arthrosis or things like that. So it can be really interesting. But all the measurements that we got here, and in this body shape can be important index to create a new index that could be the new BMI of the future. So this is, I think, an important aspect to consider. But we do not have only the sternal part of the body. We, in Instituto Oxologico Italiano, of course, we being an hospital, we also have the CT scan. And as you know, CT scan are used to understand what happened inside our body. So to see inside our body. As you know, with this technique, we can see the internal parts, so the organs of the body. For example, here we see some organs, and we can also create some models of the internal organs. In the body project, body pass project, we created also model of internal organs. And at this purpose, I show you the slide, this one. And as you can see, you can have, for example, specific measurements of the organs, as you can see here. Why to have this? Because for first thing that I come in my mind is that can be very, very useful, for example, for diagnostic tools, as diagnostic tools, to monitor time by time the progress. For example, let's think to obese patients that come and is doing some treatment for obesity, and we want to see not only the weight the weight and the other body shape progress, but we want also to see which are the progress of the internal bodies, if any. So what we did is to create models of internal organs to monitor also these internal organs in time by time to see the progress in recovery from specific disease or problematic issues like can be obesity or other issues. Okay, and this is, I think, an important aspect of the human of BodyPass project. Another thing that I think it's important to bring to your attention is another use of 3D body scan. That is the use that we can do to create avatars. This means not relevant for medical issues, but actually is really, really important. Why is important? Because if I have an avatar of yourself, I can do think that from a psychological and clinical medical point of view are crucial. For example, at Istituto Oxologico Italiano, we created a cave that is a room of virtual reality. As you can see here, if you look with attention here, this is an angle, you see? So this is like a room, as you can see. It's not just a wall, it's a wool room. And I am inside this room. This is the individual inside the room. And I am inside this room. And all in the room, I see all the things that I want to show, for example, virtual reality environment. Here, this is a city. But as you can see, for example, here, there are avatars. So which avatars can I include? I can include your friends. I can include yourself. I can include, for example, yourself with a different body. One of the things that we did, for example, in Oxologico is to include the avatar of yourself with a different body to try to understand in obese patients, in anorexia patients, if this can create something, stimulate some part of the brain that bring you to conceptualize differently the body, your body, and the environment in which your body is. So to conclude, because the time is going out, of course, the conclusion are that BodyPass provides a useful tools also in clinic, also in a physical clinic like Oxologico. Improve non-invasive assessment of fat distribution, for example. Low cost or high-end scanning technologies, for example, at Incliva, our partners, they developed low-cost technologies for managing the body scan by using a mobile phone. In Oxologico, we focused on high-end solution. In particular, this high-end solution is the 3D body scan. Another conclusion is about the comfortable for use in the clinic. We tested that to use a 3D body scan in the clinic is not problematic. And this also prevents the patient's privacy because we have a system that is compliant with GDPR. And of course, we have a lot of perspective using virtual clinical settings that we can create for specific diseases. Well, I finished my presentation. So I asked to Alexandra to see if there are some any questions. I'm happy to answer to any question that you should have.
Hello, Pietro. Okay, thank you very much. I would like to ask you one question. Is there a way to create an avatar without a scanner?
Oh, wow. This is a great question because, of course, the normal idea is that we create an avatar by using a 3D body scanner or a mobile phone. This is a quite interesting question because it's about if there are any other tools to create a 3D body scanner, to create not a 3D body scanner, an avatar. And the answer arrived from Facebook because Facebook is working to a system for creating a 3D body shape, so 3D body, an avatar practically, by analyzing your pictures on your profile. So the idea is that with a big data approach, if you have a lot of pictures, thousands of pictures, you can create the 3D body shape, so the avatar of that individual, starting from the picture. This is the only one way that I have in mind to create an avatar without any 3D body scan. The alternative is to create in CAD, but to create from the scratch with software, but this is very, very, very difficult.
Okay, thank you very much. So I think it's almost the time to finish.